Today we are going to learn the detection of lead ions and zinc ions. Now, if we get a water soluble salt and we want to find that whether lead cation is there or zinc cation is there, then we can take help of reagent NaOH and NH4OH. So first, if we do with NaOH, now sample that I will show you in the demo, sample, and in that you add NaOH, first you add drop by drop. When you add drop by drop, the observation that you will be getting is gelatinous white precipitate. Gelatinous white precipitate, when I perform, you will see how it looks like. And when in this gelatinous white precipitate, we add excess of NaOH, then what will be our observation? Our observation will be that the white precipitate is soluble. Similarly, if it is lead ions, then we will not get gelatinous white precipitate, we will get chalky white PPT. Now this chalky white PPT, when we add NaOH in excess, this chalky white PPT becomes soluble. What happens with NH4OH? I will come to that later. First, let me show you the demo. This is a water soluble salt of lead. So my right side test tube is having lead component and the other test tube is having zinc. So in this I will add, this is lead and this is zinc. In this I add NaOH first drop by drop. This is chalky white precipitate. This is chalky white precipitate that we get with lead ions. Now, the second sample is our zinc cation sample. This is our gelatinous white precipitate. You will see something like gelatin floating. And something is sticking to the walls also. See? It is sticking to the walls. That is why it is called gelatinous white precipitate. Now, second step, I add in excess. The precipitate becomes soluble. This is what is written here, that the precipitate becomes soluble if it is a lead cation. Now, let's see what happens to the gelatinous white precipitate when we add NaOH in excess. The precipitate becomes soluble. So it means with NaOH, the behavior of lead cations and zinc cations is same. So we should never ask for NaOH if we have to distinguish between zinc ions and lead ions. So which is our chemical which we should resort to? We should resort to ammonium hydroxide. It's going to help us in identification of Pb2+ and Zn2+. So what is the procedure? Procedure is same. Take small amount. Again, first I am putting lead and then I am putting zinc water soluble salt. Procedure is same. Now instead of NaOH, I use ammonium hydroxide. Now I add ammonium hydroxide drop by drop. Again, I get chalky white PPT, drop by drop. Now, I add to the water soluble zinc salt also. I get same observation, that gelatinous white precipitate. You can see it sticking to the walls. And it was not happening here, chalky white PPT. There's a difference. You can see something sticking. Here, there is no sticky thing. Now, in this, I add excess of ammonium hydroxide, which is our sample where I am suspecting lead. The PPT remains insoluble. This is the difference in observation, the PPT remains insoluble. If I will leave this test tube in the test tube holder, you can see the PPT is settling down. Now, with this gelatinous, what happens? If I add this ammonium hydroxide in excess, the PPT becomes soluble. So ammonium hydroxide is the right chemical that we should ask if we have to distinguish between water soluble lead salt and water soluble zinc salt. Because if it is ammonium, if we are using ammonium hydroxide, the lead cation in excess gives a chalky white PPT that is insoluble. You can see that the precipitate is settling down. But in here, case of zinc, there is no PPT. So this is the right chemical to be selected for distinguishing between lead ions and the zinc ions. Thank you.